Hello. Our topic for today is the history of agriculture in Belize. We will discuss some of the major efforts at agricultural production in our country. Our first farmers were the Archaic people who came after the Paleo-Indians but before the Maya, who were the first large-scale farmers in Belize. Our Archaic people were the first farmers to start producing food crops. Their products were mainly root crops, including cocoa, manioc, a type of cassava, and sweet potatoes. After the Archaic people, the Maya took a more advanced approach to producing their food. This meant that they were able to produce more food, and they were able to produce food in a shorter time span throughout the year. Their crops included corn, beans, pumpkins, as well as numerous fruits. The corn that they produced gave them the energy in their diets that they needed. The beans gave them the proteins needed to maintain their muscles and their immune systems, etc. These are examples of agriculture prior to the arrival of Europeans. The first major agricultural industry in which Europeans engaged was sugarcane production. According to the Colonial Guardian of 1902, the first farmer to begin producing sugarcane as a commercial crop was a man by the name of Don Justo Rejon. He rented land from a magistrate by the name of James Welch. In this way, sugar was exported to England from 1857, and it evolved to become the major industry that it is today in Belize. Coconuts were another major crop in the 1800s. Creole families like the Hunters and the Hydes owned vast acreages on the Keys and on the coast. This industry declined in the 1960s due to effects of hurricanes and disease. More recently, new plantings of disease-resistant hybrid coconuts have been established in the Stone Creek district. Bananas were the first crop that Belizeans of African heritage used to earn money after slavery. The farms were at places like Mullins River, Monkey River, Riversdale, and Stone Creek. A British firm named the British Honduras Syndicate then took over the industry and concentrated it at Melinda, west of Stone Creek Town. The early 1900s saw the United Fruit Company of the United States establish itself as the biggest investor in the industry. The UFC got many concessions of land and a railway from the government. The UFC also caused Panama disease to come to Belize. This disease brought the industry to a standstill between the 1920s and the 1970s, when the Belize government invested to revive the industry. Bananas are now a major export industry which bring in about $70 million to Belize annually. In 1913, three banana farmers imported and planted 900 grapefruit trees in Sarawi and Pomona. These men were Dr. Brown, Mr. Vine, and W.A.J. Bowman. Each imported 300 trees from Florida. In the early industry, fresh fruit were exported and grapefruit sections were exported in cans to the United Kingdom, to the Caribbean, and to the United States. The factory was located at Pomona. The farms grew, and 64 farmers in the industry reached the $1 million mark in 1954, and by 1962, Salada Foods introduced the production of citrus concentrate at its new factory in Alta Vista. The rice industry. Belizeans have long appreciated eating rice. Africa had its own type of rice and the slaves were familiar with its production. In 1935, the British brought a rice expert, Mr. Daniel Darius Haynes, seen here, to guide rice production in Belize. Along with Mr. Clifford Atkins from Belize City, Haynes introduced rice production to the Maya of the Toledo district around 1936. The heavy rains in the south meant that irrigation could not be controlled, and floodings of the rice fields were frequent. The government then initiated a project aimed at full mechanization of rice cultivation at the Muscle Creek Rice Station between Barrel Boom and Bermudan Landing, both in the Belize district. Mr. Clifford Atkins and a Texan by the name of Stanton Morrison managed the station. The station was sold to Tennessee Agriculture Limited in 1958. Other major players to start rice production in Belize were Big Falls Ranch Limited and Mennonite farmers in Blue Creek. Cardi and the Taiwanese Mission have also helped Belize to become self-sufficient in rice. The beef industry. Prior to 1946, cattle in Belize were used to haul mahogany. You can get a description on this in our video entitled The First Industries of Belize, which is located on this website. The first veterinarian was hired by government in 1947, and some production experiments were started at the Mountain Pine Ridge. By 1970, an export company called Belize Meat Packers was started and was exporting beef to the United States and to Martinique for a short period. One of the most successful cattle producers in Belize was a man by the name of Mr. Aaron Benjamin Bosman Arnau. He supplied Belize City with beef via the George August Meat Shop. He also provided the station prize for the cross-country race, which was a young bull. Pork production. Pig production was concentrated in the Toledo district. During World War II, processors began producing sausages, hams, bacon, and salami. During this time, swine flu crossing the border from Mexico into Belize was often problematic. By the early 1980s, however, Francis Geggs, Mr. Porky, and Eskander Bedran's Running W brand were producing sausages and hams for the local market. In the north of the country, attempts were made to start a pineapple industry in 1952. The seed material was gotten from Garifuna farmers in Barranco. 53 tons were canned in 1953, but by 1955, 300 tons of pineapples rotted in the fields as there were no tin cans in the factory or no tin cans in the country. In the 1990s, farmers from the Trio Village area got into the business, and CPBL now processes pineapples 3 times per year. Another major industry has been cacao. The Maya grew this crop and were followed by Kramer Estate in the 1880s. Government invested in cacao from the 1940s to the 1970s, and Hershey Foods Corporation attempted a major project on the Hummingbird Highway. Organic cacao is now the major thrust of the cacao industry, and this was started by the Toledo Cacao Growers Association working with Craig Sams and Joe Farley, who were British entrepreneurs. When the Mennonites arrived in 1958, poultry production was one of their first interests. Shortly after, Reimer's Feed Mill and Friesen Hatcheries began serving the industry. Belizeans now consume about 109 pounds of poultry meat on a yearly basis and about 141 eggs per year. Mangoes. In 1966, a 1,000-acre mango farm was established on the Southern Highway near to Mango Creek. The second major mango farm was established at Wright Ridge Farm on the Coastal Highway. Aquaculture. Soon after independence, General Shrimp, Belize's first shrimp farm, was established on the Senes River in the south of Belize. A few years later, Maya Mariculture was established north of Ladyville and at Cucumber Beach. Maya Mariculture later became Nova Shrimp Farm. Shrimp farming technology was brought to Belize by Dr. John Snell, along with Taiwanese investors, Chinese Belizean investors, and American investors like Keith Jackson. Shrimp aquaculture is now a major activity that brings in over $65 million annually. The major farms are Paradise, Aquamar, Texmar, Royal Mayan, and Belize Aquaculture Limited. Papayas are another major industry that developed after independence. Its development was supported by Babco, a company which U.S. aid helped Belize to set up. J.R. Brooks is now the major exporter, and the industry earns Belize about $23 million annually. Over the past 15 years, the government has dedicated a certain amount of energy in the onion and potato industries. These efforts are designed to achieve import substitution. The Taiwanese have also helped with appropriate post-harvest handling technologies of potatoes and onions. The most recent efforts in these crops has been in the production of carrots. I suspect that a lot of the carrots that are produced locally end up in Marie Sharp's pepper products. Recent efforts at agricultural diversification have included efforts in tilapia production. A large super-intensive farm called Fresh Catch was built on the Cebuan River at La Democracia. This farm was started at a time when feed prices and fuel prices were high, and the farm eventually ended up in receivership. The government has also promoted tilapia farming by small farmers. However, the small farmer efforts in tilapia production have relied on rainfall, which has meant that ponds often go dry during the dry season. In summary, we would like to conclude that Belizean farmers have invested in sugar, citrus, cacao, papayas, rice, beans, and other crops for the export and domestic industries. In the year 2000, the major industries were sugar, bananas, citrus, papaya, and marine products. Over the last 10 years, we see that agriculture has remained stable, but the exports have not grown. We need to change this for the better. We have more information like this in the book soon to be released called A History of Enterprise in Belize, which is to be released in September of 2013. We ask you to please continue visiting BelizeInfoCenter.org as we are updating our content on a continuous basis. This video was produced by Interlogic Publishers, which is located at 14 Toucan Avenue in Belmopan. I can be reached at friends@BelizeInfoCenter.org, or you can call me if you have inquiries at 601-6055. Thank you for watching this video.